Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel. Prince Harry will look back and regret Nexit. Prince Harry and Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, are spending their first few months outside of the British royal family, a lot differently than they anticipated. The Sussexes' exit from the firm came after years of scrutiny and unfair treatment by the press and public. In the end, the Duchess, with her American origins, mixed race heritage, and outspokenness, never quite fit in with the traditional British institution. As a result, the Duke and the Duchess decided that they'd be happier forging their own path outside of the royal family, and all of the rules that come with it. Though Meghan and Prince Harry had a concrete plan for Mexit, no one could have predicted the coronavirus, COVID-19, pandemic would ravage the globe. Instead of a splashy announcement regarding their next steps, the Sussexes have been living in a temporary Los Angeles compound, unable to work or reach their audience and fans in any real way. In fact, one royal expert is convinced Prince Harry will regret Mexit sooner than later. Prince Harry misses his family. Though the prince has been adamant that it was ultimately his choice to walk away from the royal family, it was still a difficult choice. Harry said during a speech at a dinner for his charity, Centibale, "The decision that I have made for my wife and I to step back is not one I made lightly. It was so many months of talks after so many years of challenges.
And I know I haven't always gotten it right, but as far as this goes, there really was no other option."
Still, amid the virus, Prince Charles' diagnosis, and the easing of tensions between himself and his older brother Prince William.
"We've got some breaking news to bring you, and it's to do with the Prince of Wales. He has tested positive for coronavirus."
The Duke of Sussex is finding it challenging to be so far from home. An insider told Entertainment Tonight, "Harry has been staying in touch with his father and loves his grandmother. Harry misses his family. Prince Harry would be welcomed back to the British royal family." Royal photographer Arthur Edwards explained to The Sun, "From his tumultuous teen and early 20s through today, Prince Harry has always been loved and embraced by the people of the UK, even when he's been rebellious. Therefore, he would be accepted back into the fold in a heartbeat should he ever decide to return. The love this country has for him has never stopped. As far as the nation is concerned, he is still the number one member of the royal family." His new life in Los Angeles, especially amid social distancing rules and quarantining, certainly can't be what the prince expected it would be. However, one royal expert is convinced he will be homesick for the UK in no time. Royal expert Katie Nichols said, "With the royals in isolation, there isn't much they can do. Although I suspect Harry will probably be feeling far from home right now, they won't want to take any risks by traveling, and their priority is to keep Archie settled and in a routine. I think they will come to the UK when it is safer to do so." Prince Harry could look back and regret Mexit. Though he's doing what's best to protect his wife after years of turmoil, Prince Harry might look back at this period in his life and regret it. Many royal fans and sources are concerned that the Sussexes' move to Los Angeles was the wrong thing to do, especially since they are seeking a more private and peaceful life. Royal author Robert Jobson told Hollywood Life, "I think it's very disappointing. I think he will look back at that and regret that. He has now been separated from his entire family in a degree of acrimony. He has none of his friends over there. He's basically isolated on the things that he loved, the military side of things, that's been taken away from him. I've known well enough Harry since he was a little boy, and he loved the military since he was a little boy. I feel that he's gonna regret this has happened." Jobson went on to express that he feels the Duchess of Sussex should have given her role more time. He says, "It was a great role that Meghan got. She gave up on it too soon. The biggest role of her life, and she gave up on that. She could have asked for more help, a little more time, and it would have been given to her." Another report: this is Meghan Markle's real name and title. Long before Meghan Markle met Prince Harry, fans recognized her as Rachel, as in Rachel Zane, her character on the TV series Suits. Interestingly enough, she actually has the same name as her on-screen counterpart. In fact, Her birth name is Rachel Meghan Markle. This isn't exactly a secret, but the fact that Markle has been going by her middle name did make headlines when her son Archie's birth certificate was finally made public in early April 2020. For the record, Archie was born on May 6, 2019. On April 4, 2020, Page Six reported that, in addition to the Rachel revelation, Markle's occupation was listed on the birth certificate as well. Sadly, there isn't a mention of her time on Suits or her stint as a Deal or No Deal briefcase model, although both would be great additions to the royal document. Instead, the birth certificate listed Markle's job as Princess of the United Kingdom. But wait, wasn't she given the Duchess of Sussex title by Queen Elizabeth on her wedding day? What is going on? Is there a Princess Rachel? Meghan Markle's real first name was mentioned long before the birth certificate reveal. Although some royal family enthusiasts may be a bit shook by the Rachel of it all, the supposed breaking news is actually old news. During a rapid-fire Q&A for the British show Dave, Meghan Markle was asked if she had a middle name. In response she shared, "Yes, it's Meghan. My first name is actually Rachel." Considering the fact that Markle did the Q&A in February 2016, her answer wasn't global news at the time. That's because, even though Markle had her first date with Prince Harry in July 2016, she wouldn't be linked to the royal until October 2016, per Town and Country. Long story short, she wasn't nearly as well known as she is today. That being said, this Rachel news was dropped in a pretty public fashion when Markle and Harry got engaged. However, it didn't make as big of a splash. Queen Elizabeth used Markle's birth name when she wrote an official letter giving her consent to the couple's marriage. The statement read, "My lords, I declare my consent to a contract of matrimony between my most dearly beloved grandson Prince Henry Charles Albert David of Wales and Rachel Meghan Markle, which consent I am causing to be signified under the Great Seal and to be entered in the books of the Privy Council." Oh yeah, Harry doesn't go by his first name either. Meghan Markle's royal title is a bit confusing. When Meghan Markle married Prince Harry, Queen Elizabeth designated her the Duchess of Sussex. Even Prince Harry got another title as a wedding gift, the Duke of Sussex. In addition to being a duchess, the Suits alum is a princess, just don't call her Princess Meghan. Or Princess Rachel, for that matter. The Mirror reported that while she was given the title the Duchess of Sussex by the Queen on her wedding day, she is also technically a princess, just not in her own name. Instead, she is Her Royal Highness Princess Henry of Wales. The title is through her husband Harry, of course. This whole not using their first names thing really affects a lot, doesn't it? Although the princess label on the birth certificate threw some people off, it shouldn't come as a surprise. Kate Middleton, who is the Duchess of Cambridge, also listed princess as her job title on the birth certificates for all three of her kids, according to the Mirror. The real question is, does all of this even matter post-Nexit? The couple may have given up their Sussex Royal Instagram account, but they can still be called the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. The Queen confirmed this in a statement she shared in January 2020. However, they did lose their HRH titles, which means Markle will no longer be referred to as Her Royal Highness. Now she has the best of both worlds, freedom from royal constraints, and she's still referred to as a Duchess. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. If you have any suggestions for us, please leave your comments below. Don't stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.